Hello everyone, welcome to my channel 212. Today we are going to continue with our chapter Force and Laws of Motion. So we will be discussing about the numericals which are related to the second law of motion. We have already done this once. This is part 2. So the questions which were there in the description box below in the previous video. So we are going to solve those questions today. Let's begin. So the first question that I have is that a certain force exerted for 1.2 seconds raises the speed of an object from 1.8 meter per second to 4.2 meter per second. Later, the same force is applied for 2 seconds. How much does the speed change in 2 seconds? So now let's see. So as I have said earlier also, first you need to mention everything that you know. Now it says that a certain force, so force we don't know, the force is question mark, exerted for 1.2 seconds. So time is 1.2 seconds. Raises the speed of an object from 1.8 meters per second to 4.2. So u is 1.8 meter per second. And v is 4.2 meter per second. So this is my initial velocity. This is my final velocity. Later the same force is applied for 2 seconds. How much does the speed change in 2 seconds? So now first we need to calculate this force. Later the same force, so let the value of force be F. So later the same force F is applied for 2 seconds. Now T2 is 2 seconds. And how much does the speed change in 2 seconds? So for this, this is U1, V1. For this, my U2 will be my final, initial velocity will be the final velocity, right? So it will be 4.2 meter per second. And it is asking for V2. Now that is my question. So from this, I can calculate, I can say that I will get F1 and from this, I will get F2. But it says that F1 and F2 are same. So what I will do is, F1 is equal to F2, both are same, is equal to MV1 minus U1 by T1. Since force is applied on the same mass, so I will take it as M. Now here also MV2 minus U2. Divided by T2. Now M and M, these two will get cancelled because they are same, right? And on the either side of the equal sign. So now my V1 is 4.2 minus U1 is 1.8 divided by T1 is 1.2 is equal to V2. I need to find V2 minus 4.2 divided by T2 is 2. So it's very simple. You just need to follow the formula. So from here I'll get I'll move this 2 up, so next I will get 4, that is 2 times 2 is equal to V2 minus 4.2. I'll move this here, so I will get V2 is equal to 8.2 meter per second. So this is the final velocity that I have. I hope the question is clear to you. The question said that a constant ascertain force exerted for 1.2 seconds raises the speed of an object from 1.8 meter per second to 4.2 meter per second. Later the same force is applied for a duration of 2 seconds. How much does the speed change in 2 seconds? Okay. Now since this is my final velocity, so now this will become my initial velocity for the second time. That's why U2, I need to find V2. Now from this, F is equal to MA is my formula, right? From this, I will get my F1 by using A is V minus U by T. Similarly, I get F2 from here. Now, the question says the same force is being applied. That means F1 is equal to F2. So, F1 is mass into acceleration. Acceleration is V minus U divided by T. So, I get V1 minus U1 divided by T1. Similarly, for F2, I get V2 minus U2 divided by T2. Since M, the mass, is same for both the sides. So, I'll cancel them out. I'll get V1, U1, T1, V2, U2, T2. I'll put in the V1, U1, T1 value and V2, U2 and T2 value here. So, the term that is missing is V2. I'll solve it to get my final yield. Do not forget to put the units. It's very, very important. Let's do the next question. Okay. So, the next question says, a constant force acts on an object of mass 5 kg for duration of 2 seconds. It increases the object's velocity from 3 cm per second to 7 meter per second. Find the magnitude of the applied force. Now first part will solve. So it is saying a constant force acts on an object of mass. So the mass is, that is m, right? Mass is 5 kg for duration of 2 seconds. So the time that I have t is 2 seconds. It increases the object's velocity from 3 cm per second to 7. So my initial velocity u is 3 cm per second. Now check the unit. This is centimeter. I need to convert it into meter. Last time also I told you there is a very simple process to do it. So this is 3 cm per second. So 3. I need to convert the centimeter into meter. So 1 meter is 100 centimeters. So I will divide this by 100. That would be for meter. Second, I want as it is. Simple. So it is 3 by 100 meter per second. Now, the final velocity that I have is 7 meter per second. Check the units. The units are same for both the sides, right? Find the magnitude of the applied force. Now, F is equal to ma, which is equal to a is what? V minus u divided by t. Now, m I have been given is 5, v 7 minus 3 by 100, right? So, 3 by 100. Divide. Either you can write this as 0.03 or you can write it like this. So t is 2. What I'll do is I'll take the LCM. So when I take the LCM inside, I will get 100. 700 minus 3 divided by 2. Right? Now this will be how much? 697 divided by 100. 6.97. So I will get my F as 5 times 6.97 divided by 2, or so this and the unit will be Newton. Do not forget the unit. Now the question says, now if the force were applied for a duration of 5 seconds, so the time has changed, the time has now become 5 seconds. So this was part 1 and part 2 says time is 5 seconds. What will be the final velocity of the object? I need to find the final velocity. So I have the force. So F is equal to ma is equal to mv minus u divided by t. Force I have got as 17.43 is equal to mass is 5 divided by 5. And the question says find the final velocity. Final velocity that was mine was now become the initial velocity, yes. So this u I will put here. Now this u is how much? 7. Understood? Is it clear? Now I will get 17.43 is equal to V minus 7. So V is equal to, I'll add these two, 24.43 meter per second. I hope this is clear to you. The mass, time, U, V were given to me. We were asked to find F. So U I converted centimeter per second to meter per second. Then I found the force and the unit is Newton. The question said that the same force is being applied. Obviously it's a constant force, right? The same force is being applied and I need to find the final velocity. So the final velocity of my previous question becomes my initial velocity for the second part. Now this initial velocity I'll put in the u. I need to find v, I'll put m, I'll put v, I'll put f, and the final velocity that I get is 24.43 meter per second. I hope it's clear to you. Let's continue to the now. The next question says, a motor car is moving with a velocity of 108 km per hour and it takes 4 seconds to stop after the brakes are applied. Calculate the force exerted by the brakes on the motor car if its mass along with passenger is 1000 kg. Now first let's see what all is given to us. So it says that a motor car is moving with a velocity of 108 km per hour and it takes 4 seconds to stop after the brakes are applied. Now in the question, the initial velocity that the person says it has is 108 km per hour. Now I need to convert this kilometer per hour into meter per second, right, for the standardization. So it will be 108 for kilometer to turn into meter per second. So how many kilometers are there in a meter? 1000, right? 1000 divided by how many seconds are there in an hour? 3600. You can simply do it by dividing by 5, multiplying it by 5 by 18 as well. So what I get next is, I'll cancel these two zeros. 6 6 6 1 18 6 3 0. So I'll get it as 30 meter per second. Now what is my final velocity? 0 meter per second, because the vehicle is coming to rest after traveling that much. Now the question says it continues, time taken is 4 seconds. So t is 4 seconds, I'll write this as t is 4 seconds. Calculate the force exerted by the brakes on the motor car if its mass along with the passenger is 1000 kg. So the mass it says is 1000 kg. Now simple, I need to find the force. What is the formula? Mass into acceleration. What is acceleration? Mv minus u divided by t. Right? Let's put in the values. So for m, I have 1000. For v, I have u 0 minus 30 divided by 4. So what I'll get is 1000 into 30, and the minus sign will go in front, divided by 4. So I'll cut it. I'll get 20 by 3 is 75, 2 zeros minus and Newton. This is my final answer. So the force that is exerted by the brakes on the motor car is 7500 Newton. Now why the minus sign? Because the force is applied by the brakes. So according to Newton's third law, equal and opposite forces acting, you apply a force of this much Newton, and in reverse the brakes also apply the force. So that's it. Now let's move on to the next question. So the next question says that a force of 5 Newton gives a mass m1 an acceleration of 10 meter per second square, and a mass m2 an acceleration of 20 meter per second square. What acceleration would it give if both the masses were tied together? Now we have done this type of question earlier also, we'll just repeat it. So now the force, that is F, is 5 Newton. This will be constant for the whole part. And so for m1, the acceleration that we have is 10 meter per second square. And for m2, the acceleration that we have is 20 meter per second square, right? What acceleration would it give if both the masses were tied together? So I need to find A for m. Now my m is m1 plus m2. So I need to find m1 and m2 so that I can find m and then A, right? Simple process. So first let's find m1 and m2. According to Newton's second law, F equals ma, so m1 is F divided by A1. What is my F? 5. What is my A1? 10. So I will get it as 0.5 m1, so kg. Next I have m2. m2 will be F by A2. F is 5. A2 is 20. And so I will get it as 0.25 kg. Now I need to find the final mass. The final mass is m1 plus m2. What is my m1? m1 is 0.5 kg plus m2 is 0.25 kg, and thus finally I have 0.75 kg. This is my final mass. My final force is how much? 5 Newton. I need to find A. So using the Newton's second equation, F equals ma, 5 is equal to m is 0.75 times A. So I get A as 5 divided by 0.75. Now I can remove this decimal and I can multiply 100 in the numerator, right? So 25 threes are, 25 fours are, 5 fours are 20 divided by 3. And since we need to find the acceleration, so it will be meter per second square. This is my final answer. I hope now you will be able to do such kind of questions. You just need to see the question. What the question is asking, what is the thing that is missing, and what is the formula you should use. Let's do the next question. So the next question says, for how long should a force of 100 Newton, for how long, so that means we need to find T. For how long should a force of 100 Newton acts on a body of mass 20 kg so that it acquires a velocity of 100 meter per second. Now since 100 meter per second needs to be acquired, so this is my final velocity. Whenever in the question you are given that you need to find time or anything and the initial velocity is not given, you assume it to be zero. Why so? This is so because if the question says that an object is starting from rest, or what is this, if the final velocity needs to be this. So in this kind of question, it is assumed that the object or the car or anything is moving from the starting point, that is, it is starting from the position of rest. So So that is the reason why we'll take the initial velocity to be zero. Right? In this question, we will use the second equation. So the second equation goes by F equals ma equals mv minus u divided by t. Now F is 100 is equal to m is 20 v minus u. So 100 minus 0 divided by t we need to find. Now 100 is equal to 20. So now 100 minus u is 100 only divided by t. I'll move this t up, I'll move this 100 down. So what I get, t equals 20 times 100 divided by 100. This 100 and this 100 will get cancelled out and I will get 20 seconds. This is my final answer. See, the questions are very easy. It's just you need to remember this basic formula to solve it. This is the key. You write down what you know, you write down what you need to find, you write the formula, you apply it and you find the answer. Simple. Question, it says a 150 gram ball traveling at 30 meter per second strikes the palm of player's hand and is stopped in 0.06 seconds. Calculate the force exerted by the ball on the land. Now mass, it says, is 150 gram. So convert this gram into kg, that is by dividing by 1000, right? Dividing by 1000. Traveling at 30 meter per second strikes the palm of player's hand and is stopped. So that means the final velocity is 0 meter per second. And the initial velocity is 30 meter per second, right? And is stopped in time given to us is 0.06 seconds. So now you have v, u, t. You can find the a from this using the formula v minus u divided by t. You have m, so you can use f equals ma to find the force. Next question. A body of mass 1 kg is kept at rest. So the mass is 1 kg and it is kept at rest. So u is 0 meter per second. A constant force of 6 Newton starts acting on it. Find the time taken by the body to move through a distance of 12 meter. Now in this question, the person has given us the distance. So the distance that we have, the distance I'll write as S, we have 12 meter. Fine? So now here we need to find the T. Right? It's very simple. I'll tell you how. So I have been given the initial velocity, I have not been given the final velocity, I have been given the mass and the force. So F is equal to ma, which is equal to mv minus u divided by t, right? From here, the force I can put, the mass I can put, I will say this has to be v and this will be u divided by t. So I have 6 equals m is 1 times v as it is minus u will be 0 divided by t, right? So from here, what I'll get is V by T is equal to 6. Correct? 1 times this. Now this is a very good question because velocity is basically distance divided by time. So I can write V as S by T divided by T is 6. Here I will replace the S with 12. So I'll get this formula I can write as S divided by T square equals 6. S is 12 divided by T square is 6. So from here, this t square, I'll move this up and this down, right? T square is 12 divided by 6, which is 2. So t is square root of 2, which is how much? 1.414 seconds. This is your final time period. It was a very good question. Please do this question in your notebook also. That a body of mass 1 kg is kept at rest. A constant force of 6 Newton starts acting on it. Find the time taken by the body to move through a distance of 12 meter. I'll be putting two more questions in the descriptive box. Please do try to solve them. Do share your answers with us so that I can confirm whether you have done it correctly or not. Thank you so much. Stay tuned, stay safe, stay healthy. And please log into our channel so that you can check the next video, that is a third law of motion. So we will be starting with that in our next class. Till then, bye.